Every weekend across Britain, parents are allowing their children to take part in an increasingly popular sport, Thai boxing.
Come on, princess, go forward, Bill. Kick him here. Kick him.
Let's see go. I'll set him up. Push, you fucking push, that's all.
This is the story of five primary school children, their parents, and the journey to the biggest fights of their young lives. 10-year-old Ty is after a European belt. 9-year-olds Sohan and Connor are going head-to-head for a British belt. 5-year-old twins Mia and Kian are preparing for their very first fight at an adult show. And two of the boys will be fighting each other at Cage Brawl. Welcome to Baby Fight Club. There are now over 500 registered Thai boxing clubs teaching children in Britain. It's a self-regulated amateur sport. There is no official minimum age, and rules vary from club to club.
Straight in, lad! Again, Kian! Kian! Come on, Kian! Punch him, Kian! Twist him! Twist him! Harder, Kian! Come on, Kian!
Quantities of air, Darren and his wife, male technician Lisa, enrolled their 5-year-old twins in Thai boxing lessons 7 months ago.
So I was a sceptical one because I'm thinking, well, will they adapt, will they not? They're only babies. You can't turn around and say you're not going because it's like World War III. They're that eager to get in there.
They didn't want to fight, they won't fight, would they?
Switch!
At home in Wigan, Darren has converted the spare room into a gym, and three times a week he trains his 5-year-old twins, Mia and Kian.
I think I've got more of a bond with my kids doing Thai boxing than just the everyday man who doesn't do anything. Boom. Yeah. I come home from work, I go Thai boxing with them. Sure. I don't think Thai boxing makes kids bullies. I don't think in one shape or form, but they'll protect themselves. Do you know what I mean? It makes children more positive.
Brilliant! Come on!
What do you like about fighting? Trophy. And where else? Where else?
Winning.
Good girl.
Mum Lisa leaves the training to her husband, but she does have a crucial role on fight day.
Eh? Not to cry, have we? Lies, what happens? And what comes off?
Bye-bye.
You sparkle. Blink.
All made up, Mia is ready to face her fourth opponent, but even the sparkle doesn't disguise her pre-fight jitters.
Come on, baby.
Oh, she's crying.
Come on. Come on. Just enjoy yourself. Come on.
Every time Mia goes in that ring, there's always a worry that she's going to start crying. Because as soon as she starts crying, it faces a lump to your throat. Well, sometimes Mia needs that little bit of a push and injection to get her motivated in ring.
I'm coming in now. Come on.
Stop this now.
Oh, show you. Come on. Come on. You win first, I'll come in second. That's it.
Come on, princess! Come on, princess, go forward, Mia! Kick her, Mia! Kick her! Kick her, princess! Go on, Mia, lose it! Come on! Go on, Mia! That's
kicks it. And punches to the head are not allowed, so the referee steps in.
Go on, Mia! That's it, Mia! Go on, Mia! Kick her, Mia! Do it now, princess! Go on, Mia! Go on, princess! Princess! Do it now!
Novice Mia has had to settle for a consolation prize today.
Well, you're annoyed when your children lose. I'm not going to stand there and say it didn't bother me, because it did bother me. But after I came back and had a talk to Mia about Thai boxing, I actually sat there and said, we don't have to do it anymore if you don't want. I said, we don't have to train, we can do something else. We can go ballet dancing if you want, or disco dancing. She said no. She doesn't want to go ballet dancing. She's a proper little girl, but she likes Thai boxing.
Dad Darren is pinning his hopes on Mia's next fight. In East London, one mum knows all about the ups and downs of the fight game.
If anyone's watching, you cannot get a decent groin guard for a junior.
Her 9-year-old son, Connor, has been competing for 3.5 years.
Top
friend's little boy up in the flats over there. He was going, and I don't let them play out. And so I just wanted to get him into something after school and that, and he went there and he loves it.
I fight all the time, that's why. In school I do all my kickboxing moves, but I'm not allowed, but when someone calls me names or hits me, I hit him back. And I went on his head by accident. And then he come back again the next day. Oh, that was an hard shot, that really hurt. Got a big lump on his head out there.
He's always got to fight kids heavier, but at the end of the day, it's made him stronger. Wait, so
wait.
Don't bother me.
I see you.
Go, Connor, stay on him! Stay on him!
Connor's mum, Nikki, is always ringside. At his early competitions, she had a special way of bringing out the best in her little fighter.
I tell you, that boy called me a name, so that gets you fired up.
Yeah.
What's that?
A boy, if my mum...
Whoever's going here, I go, Con, you did it. You won't believe what he just called me. And it winds him up, gets him fired up.
That's it, Connor! That's it! Yeah. Now, what's that? What a push! A fucking push! That's hard, isn't it?
I don't like it when they throw me, because it hurts. Because
they just pick you up by your head and throw you. It's dangerous, really, sometimes.
Connor's already Southern Area champion. His next title fight is for the British belt, and then he's got his debut at Cage Brawl. His opponent in the cage is veteran fighter Ty Barlow. He's already won 6 British belts and knocked out 2 opponents. At just 10 years old, he runs over 15 kilometres every week, does over 400 sit-ups, and spends more than 10 hours sparring. His dad is his trainer, and both his parents were fighters. They even named their son Ty after their first love.
This one here is featherweight British title that I won. It's strange when you knock somebody out because you just know that you've thrown a really good punch. I actually like bashing people's faces up first. That's horrible, but I've had a couple of fights and I fought a girl once, I won't tell you who it was, and I actually enjoyed splattering her nose all over her face.
Dad Mark is the only member of the family who hasn't won a belt. He had one fight in Thailand and lost.
I was rubbish, I was never a good fighter. I've always admitted that. And Maxine said, I could fight, but I wasn't anything spectacular.
Whilst Maxine works, Mark stays at home. He focuses on Ty and his double world champion sister Iman's fighting careers.
How are you, mate? Everything we do really, especially me, revolves around Thai boxing. Everything in the house is pictures of Thai fighting.
Professional coach Mark runs a popular Thai boxing club, the Assassins, from the gym at the end of the garden.
We bought the house on purpose for the land, so we could build a gym. We spent about 10 grand on it.
I do Thai boxing because I love Thai boxing.
It's a way of life, it's not like a job, it's a way of life.
Do you like your early morning runs?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Tired.
With me and his mum doing it, he had no choice. Really. As soon as he he was born, we just put him in the pushchair. He was sitting in the corner of the training, watching. So he's that's probably moulded him.
Every year since he was a toddler, Ty's parents have taken him to Bangkok to train and even fight.
Rules in Thailand, you know, punch into the face, elbowing, knees to the face, no shin pads. And that's for all ages.
Extreme martial arts for children, like Thai boxing, are taking the UK by storm. 10-year-old Thai is trained by his dad, Mark. His mum, Maxine, is an experienced fighter.
His first proper fight was at an interclub in Bournemouth, and I think he was about 2.5, 3 years old. But yeah, I think he enjoyed his first fight. He won't remember it, but he enjoyed it.
By the time Ty was 8, his parents decided he was ready to fight full Thai rules in Bangkok.
The reason why we take the kids to Thailand to fight is that they can actually do head contact. We can't do head contact in England. It's against the rules. and we wanted him to fight full Thai rules as early as possible.
Does that worry you ever as parents? Or
anything that worries you if you're a parent, you know, if a kid's playing football, you get worried. You get probably hurt more outside playing on your bike. Really?
In Britain, no one will officially sanction children fighting full Thai rules, with elbows, kicks and punches to the head, and only a groin guard, gum shield and gloves for protection.
What about you, Thai? Do you prefer fighting in England or Thailand?
Probably England, because you don't get hurt.
And unlike Britain, in Thailand there's big money at stake.
All the fights are all about betting and keeping the gamblers happy. So Thai goes out really, really slow. The Thai fighters come out because he's a little foreign boy and will come out and batter you. And they come out really fast, knock him around the ring and that lot. And the betting's going really high and he looks basically rubbish. And then the second man said, right, okay, pick it up. Not one guy out in the third round. Well, bang, 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 and knocked him out.
Mark will go anywhere to get his son experience. He's got permission to take him out of school for a warm-up fight in Latvia.
It looks like a nuclear bunker.
Tai is fighting under European rules. Kicks, punches and elbows to the head are allowed, but full protective gear must be worn.
You can knock him out easy. Cuts everywhere. Done it once, knee to knee in the face.
How did you feel when you did that?
Brilliant.
Knee! Aye! Aye! Knee! Aye!
My dream, I think his mum's dream probably would be for him to win a stadium title. And that'd be my dream. I don't know what his dream is. His probably dream is just to play with his soldiers.
Back in Wigan, Darren is preparing his five-year-olds for their next fight. As a self-made man, he believes it will teach his daughter to stand on her own two feet.
There's a bit of something special between daughter and father, and me protecting a little bit more than always. I always shouldn't think that way, but we do.
You don't like that one.
I have two of them.
Oh, will you now?
Let's, Mia at 18 years old starts going drinking round, you know, and then somebody approaches her, muscles in on her a little bit and tries to intimidate her. She's not going to be intimidated. He's going to get a broken nose.
You're not having that, lad.
It's the day of the twins' first fight at an adult show. Yeah. And their mum and dad are hoping for a win.
Mia, she just turns it on at ring. It's weird.
Like a little sweet little girl, isn't it?
And next minute, poof.
Little pit bull.
In preparation for the fight, they've been encouraging their children to put on a few pounds so they're not at a weight disadvantage in the ring.
Good girl. Well, if I knew Mia was fighting somebody who was a little bit heavier than her, and I had like 2-3 weeks, I could like bulk her up a little bit.
Eat some spaghetti. Not dare give me, yeah?
Darren's training programme includes close analysis of their previous fights.
All you had to do is give her one good push back and then carried on punching at the same time.
Did you get that?
Can't say that.
Come on.
The twins are on the billing for a big Thai boxing show organised by their club coach. They will be battling it out in front of a crowd of 400 people at the local working men's club. It's a very different environment to their previous five inter-club competitions. And Darren wants to acclimatise Mia before her rematch against the six-year-old who beat her.
Three times she's had, you know. Are you going to let her do that to you again? All right, don't let her do it. Come on. Harder. Come on. That's nothing, that, Mia. That's not going to do nothing. Come on, Mia. Waking up. Work.
Some people think that you put kids in a ring with no protective gear. All they do is see a boxing match and think it's like that, and it's not. There's a referee, and I'm not being funny, but there's all them parents out there who don't want their kid get hurt. So we're not going to put our kids in a ring where they've got knocked 10 bells out of each other. It's not going to happen.
Come on, Princess, punch! Come on, Princess, go! No! Yeah. Hey. Good girl! Again, Mia! Again!
No, 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 come on.
It's Mia's second defeat in a row, and much to her dad's disappointment, she's losing heart.
She's like well backed off now. Not interested at all.
Mia's gone into like a girly play stage. I think she's a her own little world at the moment. I think she just wants to be a little princess dancing around with her boxing gloves on.
Mia's dad is concentrating on building up her confidence before she goes back in the ring again.
Smashing the ribs.
In East London, 9-year-old Connor is eager for a British title belt to add to his growing collection.
I'd just like to win belts. The trophies are all right, but I think I prefer a belt to win than other a trophy. I just love them. Love the smell of the leather when you bring them in. That one still smells of leather. That one does. That one ain't leather. Don't think.
Mum Nikki has upped his training.
I'm a strong believer in if you do something, then you take it seriously, you get into a routine with it. And if you don't want to do it, then you don't do it full stop.
See you later, alligator.
4 times a week after school, she takes him to the gym for up to 3 hours. His coach is Terry Butwell.
It's got to be longer, it's got to come in, boom, okay?
The earlier the better. You get them early, you can teach them the technique. You'll see if they've got any heart, if they're game. Show me the boy of 7 and I'll show you the man. That's an old saying.
To give Connor the best shot at winning the British title, he's getting as much ring experience as he can.
Remember, you're jabbing to the bodyguard, yeah?
It's hard to find opponents in his weight class, but distance is no obstacle. Today, they're in Lancashire for a rematch against a local boy Connor fought a year ago.
East, 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 London! So I'm up for it. He beat me last time and he ain't getting away with it again. But the most thing I've got to do is stop him. And that's what I'm gonna do.
I'm gonna try and do.
I'm gonna.
Connor fought him last year. Same place, same venue. It was a close fight. Connor left it a bit late last time. Started getting the better of him towards the last two rounds. Took a while for him to warm up. So this time, hopefully, Connor knows he's got to go out there and overwhelm him straight away. Oh, this is how I like seeing him. He's psyched up for this one. So now he's going to go out and do the business.
You want this fight?
Yes.
Fight. Let's go.
Connor's doing well, but then a crucial point is deducted for an accidental punch to the face.
I caught him again, accidentally. Yeah, and I was, don't worry about it.
Is he for real?
Don't worry about it.
Connor,
come on, lay on him now.
Let's go!
Push in the face. Push in the face.
Okay, the judges got to the scorecards, and it's a unanimous decision in the red corner.
Disappointed.
Hurst, we knew what the decision was going to be before we got here. Unless Connor stopped him, then he wouldn't have won.
The other boy accidentally punched to the face, so did Connor. He didn't deserve to have a point taken away. It's a junior fight. They want to put our kids off. Stop.
I won that.
I know you did, but there you
we
go.
Know,
we
don't
knew
we?
That, didn't we, Connor?
Oh, no, you did. I'm well proud of you.
Connor will now go into his next fight for the British title as the underdog. He will be up against a boy 3 kilos heavier. 9-year-old Sohan Akram has had 6 fights and is undefeated.
My dream is for Sohan to become the world champion, and I know he will.
You want me to win?
I always want you to win. You're my little champ.
Zohan lives in Birmingham with his mum, dad and baby brother.
Go and get your belt, sonny. That's my little boy's trophy collection over there. All that there belongs to Zohan. Look at that. How good is that? This is Zohan's first major event and his combat with the belt. When Zohan fought the kid in the final, he was actually talking to his opponent. He was like, that belt's mine, I'm taking it home, you can't have it. He reminds me of Chris Eubank.
No one's taking this belt off me, I tell you now.
Always wanted to be the best. I've always wanted to be a champ at something. I'd always wanted people to look at me and say, look, there's the champ. But it's as good as them saying it to my son.
If a woman gets scared, I'll make them scared instead of getting me scared. I'll get them scared.
They called him the Midland Marvel.
Here he comes.
It was more
ding,
than
ding,
a marvel
ding, ding.
To me. I fought like a king when I stepped in the ring. I was proud as a father could be. He lived a dream I had forgotten for a job on the fire.
Zohan was born with severe eczema and has been bullied at his previous schools. His dad believes Thai boxing has helped him overcome this.
He was born with a scab on the back of his head, and as by 1 year's old, it spread all over his body.
But once I got out of the bath and all the water was all blood.
Yeah, because what it is, when he scratches, he weeps. Well, he used to, and he used to just constantly bleed. It actually got to a point where someone had to be covered with wet wraps. His whole body was covered, so we couldn't get to his skin because it was irritating him so bad.
In school, in my old school, they should call me Itchy.
Right, your back's pretty good. And can I stare at your face?
Because of someone's eczema, he's really aggressive. He's got so much anger inside him. You know, when I used to look at my son, I used to come back home and I used to cry. You know, no one used to see me, but I used to be so upset that my son's ill. And I used to pray to God and ask him, why me? What have I done wrong in my life for you to punish my kid in such a bad way?
If undefeated champion Zohan wins at his club's competition today, it will build his confidence for the upcoming British title fight. Mum Nazim will be watching for the first time.
Since he's started Thai boxing, since he started these fights, I always pray for him. I would like to watch him. I would like to sit there and just watch him and throughout the fight and be comfortable with it, but I'm not. But he wants me there. It's like Zohan wants me to come, and I don't want to let him down.
As a safety precaution, paramedics are ringside.
Okay, go on, son, fist up. Who's the champ?
I'm the champ.
Who's undefeated? You are undefeated.
With another win under his belt, Zohan is hungry for the British title. And this time, all his family are coming to watch.
My grandma's going to be in her... they might be nervous because this is their first time seeing me fight and they don't want me to lose. They want me to win and try my best.
My friends used to say, you feel better each time you go, but I don't. I'm still the same. I think I'll get worse. I do, because I still feel nervous. I don't know what it is. I don't think I'll ever stop being nervous, no matter how many fights he has.
all the fighters spend a lot of their childhood trying to become the best. In Leicestershire, 10-year-old Ty is on his morning run. His dad has devised a grueling training regime to prepare him for the European title fight.
I think the people who don't do nothing, catch potatoes, who don't do nothing, and the kids see him doing that, sitting down, smoking or drinking, watching TV every night, they also think that's a normal thing. And that's why so many fat kids around. Too many fat parents.
Ty's got a formidable fight record. He's been in the ring since he was a toddler and only lost 2 out of his 58 fights.
Sometimes I think that I'm doing too much and then I say, can I have a day off sometimes and then go play outside? And I say, no, you got to do some Thai boxing and learn more.
Why do you think they say that?
To get more out of me.
You know, it's all right if he's just playing, doing Thai boxing, he's just fighting normal fights, but he isn't fighting normal fights. He's fighting top-class English and European opponents, so he's got to really train that hard. Doesn't matter what age you are.
Come on! Rubbish, at the end, go!
It's for him, you know. He's good enough to fight for a European title. I mean, he's really good. He's best in his country, his age and his weight. And he deserves opportunity.
After 6 weeks hard training, champion fighter Ty is ready for his shot at the European belt.
Looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to it for once.
He'll be the headline fight at his dad's International Assassins show. Promoter Marks forked out £1,000 to arrange the fight, including flying over his Lithuanian opponent.
That's excellent. They're both the
same way. I don't mind getting hurt. You get hurt, and you can recover from it. Because little boys like me, most of the time, don't get injured. But I've had injuries before, but not bad ones. Not really bad ones.
Ty has suffered bruises and strained muscles, but nothing more serious.
Ty's got to get hurt badly yet, and I'm sure it will happen at some stage. Something's going to hurt him. You can't fight and come out unscathed. Learning curve for me, I'm not, really. We don't know how he'll react. He doesn't know. You know, there's only you and your opponent in there. It can be a really lonely place. Especially if you're on the end of a beating.
Round one.
Six.
Ty's meticulous technique is overwhelming his opponent. But his dad knows he can fight better.
Fake it, let him come in. Fake kick. Ty. Fake a kick. Ty, what are you doing? Pick it up.
Pick it up, come on.
Ty.
Work, Ty.
We do expect a lot of Ty. We expect him to fight well, I mean, every time.
That's crap. I told you to pick it up. That belt's there. You're not gonna win it where you're going.
Mark may be trying to will more out of his son, but his opponent has had enough. One of Ty's high kicks to the head stunned him. Concerned, his coach throws in the towel. Ty is crowned the WPKC Junior Under 25 Kilos European Champion.
He didn't fight that well. The fourth round would have been better. I gave him a right mouthful in the third round in the corner because he just wasn't performing. He wasn't there, you know. But as he said, I was going to pick it up for the fourth round. But, you know, he did enough, didn't he? But there's more there.
Ty's next big fight will be a first, even for him. He's fighting in a cage. His opponent will be 9-year-old Connor. But for now, Connor's mind is on the British belt.
There for Britain.
something that give all I've got to give it 110%, try my hardest and win.
Quiet. Dong Pai.
The British title fight is a chance for Conor to reclaim his ring name, Top Dog, after his defeat in Lancashire.
Oh, Conor never quits. I've never seen Conor quit and climb out the ring or anything. Never. Of course he's had a tear, he's had a cry and that, but at the end of the day, it's made him more determined. He gets back in there. He's never said he's never wanted to get back in the ring or anything. Until he says that to me, then I ain't going to mollycoddle him.
If I lose, it's not the end of the world.
Fight another day?
Yeah. Live another day.
In Birmingham, Conor's opponent, Sohan, has no intention of losing.
I have to win next week. I have to be undefeated. If I lose, then I'm going to be in a bad mood.
I've never had the opportunity to become a superstar, but my son has. Sohan's living the life I should have lived. Saturday, it's going to be a Father's Day. I mean, the clouds are going to open up and the gods are going to be looking down on the champs. Come in tomorrow. Yo, rude boy, don't let me down, you know. You get me, rude boy.
I'll be there, right?
Yeah, yeah, man.
Good luck. See you tomorrow.
It's the morning of the Junior British IKF title fight and the start of a long day for the two little boys.
Not nervous. I'm ready for it. I'm not losing in Birmingham.
Like adult fighters, Conor and Sohan have to weigh in. It's the first chance they get to size each other up.
25.8.
Sohan weighs 3 kilos more than Conor, but Conor's side have agreed to waiver this because their boy has more ring experience.
It's all right, half a kilo over, but it's all right. No, we would have given away 3 kilos, yeah, yeah, but you know, it's 28 was the max, but it's okay, it's all right, no problem.
It'll still be a good fight.
Be a brilliant fight.
Terry's agreed to let the half kilo go, but mum Nikki won't compromise when it comes to her son's protective gear. The show's rules state that it must be colour coordinated.
Check, see what he's got, because he has to wear all black.
All black?
Yes.
He's got black shin guards, black body armour.
Yeah, black gloves.
Black gloves.
That's it.
Red head guard. You know what, why weren't these sorted out before we got here?
It's not nothing to do with my association, is it?
It's too big. Look, that has an head guard. That's what he's telling me to put on my kid to fight.
I don't think so.
We're going home. He's pulled. Same ways. He's not down to us, to them.
Should have been the best fight of my life.
Terry tells Sohan's dad that the fight is off. It's a devastating blow. His son's supporters are already gathering.
Connor's been told that he needs to be colour coordinated to go into the ring. We need to sort this out, because I've got so much family coming and I ain't having my family stood up for no one.
How are you feeling about all this anyway? Does it bother you?
A little bit.
Yeah?
Do you want to fight?
You just want to get in there and get on with it now, don't you?
To be honest, I don't think I'm in.
But like, we agreed to fight, so we don't let people down.
Nikki's had a change of heart and come up with an ingenious solution to the colour coding problem.
I ain't letting him wear other people's equipment. Scabies, everything. You don't know whether someone's had crabs or what.
Oh, because some knobhead didn't tell us that you had to be colour coordinated.
Think about going in there and kicking the shit out of him. That's what you got to think about.
You know how to fight. Go in there and be the hardest, okay?
Better than him.
Yeah. He's only light.
Get this brain right. This is for you, your mum. I'm going to win this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, Conor Butler.
Hold your hands up.
Even Sohan's mum has become seduced by the occasion.
Sohan, kick.
Okay, ready? Just watch round one. And box up.
Make
It's so real for me when he's in the ring. It's as if when he gets hurt, I get hurt. And when he's punching, I'm punching at the same time.
Sohan is physically unscathed, but his confidence and his dad's dreams will need piecing together again.
Losing is such a horrible feeling. But all I can do is be there for someone, which I am. And he knows that. He can depend on me as a father.
Come on, let's go Nando's.
I won! He's hit the ceiling.
I'm the champ.
You're the man, aren't you?
The champ is in the house.
We need 3 times to keep it.
No, I'm not giving it back.
This is for Britain.
2 points, hey, who we appreciate? The Connor.
This is what I always say, get smart.
Connor's broken his losing streak and is determined to remain top dog. He's going to be taking on Britain's number one boy at his weight, 6 times British title holder and European champion, Ty Barlow.
I want to know how tall he is. I want to know what his favourite technique is. I want to know what if he goes on the back foot or the front foot. When I fight people, I get damn serious as soon as I see them. You're like psyching them out. You're like making them all nervous. Like, then they get all nervous and then they get scared. And then, but he won't get scared. He's had like about 50 fights.
Connor's opponent is indeed formidable. Ty may be just 10, but this will be his 60th fight.
Dad? What? Am I wearing these shorts? Oi.
No, you've got the fire
jaws. Oh, okay. I'm very relaxed and up for it.
Ten-year-olds Ty and Connor will be fighting in a 23-foot cage.
It's different to normal, because normally you don't fight in the cage, it's just the normal rings. It's just, there's a cage on there. There's no way out. I think they lock it. I think they do.
The champion will be decided over 5 2-minute rounds in front of a crowd of over 1,000 people.
Jeez. My God, look at that cage.
Tonight, 2 10-year-olds will, for the first time, be on the billing at Cage Brawl.
Big, isn't it? She looks like a little ant in there.
Connor and Ty will be fighting in front of over 1,000 people. Ringside tickets are £35 a head, but the children don't get paid.
I think the way of Thai boxing, some Thai boxing styles, is the cage. I think the cage is something different. Spectator sport, that's what we're looking for. Yeah.
I'm feeling all right. I think I'm going to win. I know I am. I think I am.
So it's a nice place, isn't it? It's quite big, isn't it?
For Ty's family, the cage is a move away from their purest Thai boxing roots.
We wouldn't not take it just because it was in a cage. I mean, it's an experience. But from a Thai boxing point of view, I don't think it should be in a cage.
I don't think it's more dangerous. Probably safer because it's not going to fall out of the ring. This is white, isn't it? Like you have in the garden.
So you've got to watch your backs, I suppose.
It looks good. It's like better than fighting in the ring.
Like all fighters, the boys are insured and their parents have to sign a disclaimer.
I, Conor Butler, understand that there is a risk of injury or death in competing in kickboxing, Thai boxing, karate and allied martial arts. And in the event of injury, I swear not to hold my instructor, the promoting body or promoter, fellow competitors, responsible.
Is this your first fight?
No.
Right. How many have you had?
60.
60? God, long. Bit of a veteran then.
The boys are focusing on the fight ahead. But with the rules varying from club to club, the adults still haven't agreed on what's allowed, including head contact.
Mum?
Yeah?
Why can't we have any kicks to the head?
Ty's parents seek out the referee.
He thought our one was just kicking to the head for the kids.
Yeah, we'll be kicking to the head. For the kids, no punches to the head.
We've been told there's no kicking to the head as well.
There's no kicking to the head?
Yeah.
We'll have to speak with Terry about that and you guys can agree that.
Yeah, yeah.
That thought was like normal
Thai. Oh, sorry, Mark, I didn't recognise it, yeah.
But there's no punches and kicking to the head.
Ordinary Thai boxing, low kicks, but not no kneecap kicks, that's all.
But you can kick down here.
Look, you've got R1 full contact, you've got R1 MMA, you've got R1 K1 rules, you've got R1 Thai boxing rules, and that's what they're fighting.
No kicks to the head, no punches to the head. There we go.
There you go.
Right, that's clear.
You got that time. There's so many different associations and rules, and he's safe, isn't he? There's a referee in the ring and all. If it gets out of hand or they're doing something illegal, then they get told.
The referee's from their gym.
Is he?
Yeah, he's been told.
You're joking.
Yeah. That's good, isn't it?
With a full capacity crowd, ticket sales come in at thousands of pounds.
This is the big one, I suppose. Ty is like one of the top boys to be fighting at the minute.
Hands up!
I'm quite quietly confident. I'm not overly confident. I think he'll do all right. I think Ty can beat him.
Conor will be wearing head protection, but Ty prefers to fight the authentic way.
Come on!
The adults agreed no head punches, but a few are slipping through.
Aye, aye, aye.
Yes, he can't.
Oh, what's that? He can't trip.
No, he can't. He should have had a warning for that by now.
Wait, now, hey.
Hey. He's going to start pulling forward because it'll look like Connor's the aggressor. Forward, you've got to be first. Come on, Ty. Do you want this title?
You're losing this now. You're losing this fight because you're not listening to us. Come on.
Ty, you've got to take this to him now the whole round. You look terrible.
Yeah, worst fight I've ever seen him.
Stop doing them shitty little drip kicks or whatever they are.
Look him in the eyes. He's supposed to be the best in the country. You're whooping his fucking arse. Whoop his arse even more now, yeah?
It's the final round, and with tensions rising outside the cage, the boys are feeling the pressure.
Fire, I told ya!
In the heat of the moment, more and more disallowed punches to the head are hitting home.
Come on!
Watch the head punches!
Go, I can't stay on it!
Watch the head punches!
Finish off strong! Come
tell him I'm punching you in the face, did they?
No.
I told you he'd be biased.
The junior Thai boxing title goes to, by a split decision, Connor Thompson.
For favourite Thai, it's a shock. He's only been beaten twice in his previous 59 fights and feels robbed.
Mate.
I know, but they were both punching and kicking to the face.
He started it, he retaliated. You should have told him first. Here. If you want to argue about decisions, we do it after.
No.
Look, you had a great fight. You lost the decision, simple as that. Act like a big man, yeah? Take it like a man.
He's always getting back. Right. You should have got the spot of the eye. I know. It's very good from Tom.
You
knew the judges were
against
you and everything else, so don't worry about it.
You're not smacking him. They're cheating bastards. See all them hip fires? You're not allowed to hip fire. Everybody knows that. Punches to the face, loads of them, right? And in the end, he got so pissed off, that's why he punched him in the face.
What he didn't like was referee telling his boy off. But there were two blatant headshots that had to be told off for.
I just feel sad for the other little boy, you know, because as a parent I've been there with him and this.
I felt sad for him because I think he really wanted to win.
4 weeks' time we'll fight him again and we'll beat him because he'll do proper Thai boxing rules. Okay, we still love you.
I knew Conor would win anyway because he's getting better and better, isn't he? Each fight he fights. What's next for him? Money, I suppose. Hopefully.
I want 2 Bentleys, a massive ass worth £10 million, and I'm going to build a massive pen for my dogs. Because my ass is going to be so big, it's going to be hard to keep it tidy. And I'm going to buy my dad's stuff and my mum's stuff. And I'm just going to buy everything for everyone.